I've traveled to the planet Earth to understand the conflict in Israel. Why will humans kill each other over a patch of real estate in the desert with no oil? In the previous episode, we learned about the ancient history of this land and how the British partitioned it with the intention of both sides living in harmony. Why did this plan go awry? Well, originally the British divided it into two states, and as you can tell by looking at the map, it didn't work out very well. This obviously didn't work. Look at their borders. There's random patches of color. Who'd the British get to draw their map? Jackson Pollock? Mr. Pollock, the British would be honored if you would make a map of Israel. I am inspired by the paint blotch techniques that give the dawn of a new age to art. Honestly, you're making me sick. Exactly. I vomit on the canvas to produce the Israel map. So Israeli troops went from house to house, expelling Palestinians from their homes and massacring anyone who resisted. An example of this is in Deir Yassin, where Israeli troops just opened fire, killing 150 innocent Palestinians, many of them women and children, and mutilating and raping anyone who resisted. You know it must have been a bloody massacre at Deir Yassin when the town's name itself is Yassin? My dear, have you seen Amir? Nah, he's dead. Oh, well, have you seen Khalil? Nope, also dead. Hey, have you seen...
No!
Now, in modern day, the location at Deir Yassin has been turned into a mental health center. I guess what better way for Israel to deny that these crimes ever happened than turn the site of it into a psychiatric hospital? Zionist finger-banged my uncle behind the go-go mart. I am declaring you legally insane. But there's help, because thankfully, by rare coincidence, this exact spot is a loony bin. Take him away. I'd say I want a lawyer, but they're all Jewish. I think we glossed over this a little too quick. You said that Israel rapes anyone who resists. I mean, really? Do you listen to yourself sometimes? You know, the Gaza Strip has one of the fastest population growth rates of anywhere in the world. So you don't have to rape them. These chicks are just giving it out. On the Gaza, we should drop bombs and condoms. And what is your point? Yes, maybe some Israeli soldiers committed sex crimes, but does that mean Israel should not exist? You know, many African nations have a much higher rate of sex crime, but you don't hear progressives saying we should eliminate Uganda. Why are you joining a terrorist group? To fight Israel. If they really rape the resistance, I can lose my virginity. You really never got laid? Well, I'm not counting that time in Uganda. Why don't progressives count Uganda? I don't know how much more of this I can take. The only thing being raped is my ears. And the foreign Arab leaders told the Palestinians to leave so this way they could avoid hurting these people when they attacked the Jews. So they left on their own. Well, it's true that some Palestinians left on their own, but the majority of them were expelled. Come on, if you saw your neighbors being killed, wouldn't you leave? So I told the guy who lives right there in front of the whole village, if you don't get out of your home, I'm gonna shoot you in the skull. What about the guy who lives right there? What, that guy? He left on his own. No foreign or international government has the right to disrespect their property rights. Yeah, get this. I'm debating this liberal, and he said, the government has to respect property rights. Yeah, the next time he tries to tax you, just say, but I'm a Palestinian refugee. Yeah, when I'm doing my taxes, I'll fill out on the W-4 form under expenses. I found a law. You're disrespecting this tragic period of time. This is called the Nakba, or Arabic for disaster catastrophe, when 700,000 Palestinians were expelled from their homes. If only Adolf Hitler had lived another 3 years to see this.
The Jews are better at ethnic cleansing than me.
Maybe that's why they call him the Führer.
I am furious! You are my most trusted advisor. What should I do?
I was gonna betray him, but the Jews got him first.
According to the historian Benny Morris, it's true that some Palestinians were forced to leave, but it was not a premeditated decision or plan on the part of the Israeli government. Is this the same Israeli government that quickly won the war against an enemy that outnumbered them and has a world-renowned intelligence agency, but had no idea that their troops were engaged in ethnic cleansing? Yeah, I just went to the bathroom, and when I got back, spontaneously everyone disputing our land was gone. But then our intelligence picked up enemy forces about to attack, and we coordinated our troops to those coordinates. You imbecile! The Palestinians fled because it is a war zone, as the Arab cannonballs come flying in, mutilating Israeli soldiers' bodies. You're going, how come the Israelis didn't make the Palestinians feel welcome? Like it's a safe zone at a college.
People keep calling me a man, but I feel like a Palestinian dyke, trapped in a Jew's body. Can't I just have a whole wing of a university to feel safe?
I apologize, but I'm brand new to your galaxy. What war are you talking about? Alright, let's go over it again. So the UN originally divided up the land. The Arabs didn't like this very much. Rather than take the Jews to court, they instead, in 1948, invaded to take that land back. Your land grab is in violation of international law. So you're saying the UN violated international law? The UN creates international law! You're twisting my words. What I mean is conquering land and then settling it with civilians is in violation of the law. The problem is that Arabs want it both ways. When they think they can win by violence, they fight. But if they lose, they go, what about international law? Rather than wave a white flag when Arabs surrender, they should wave UN resolutions. The Jews are coming. Do we have any more grenades to spill their blood?
That was the last one.
Plan B. Wave your UN resolution.
One love, one heart, let's get...
That was awful. Your dancing should be illegal under international law. The Jews only bought 7 to 15% of the land, while the Arabs owned the other 85% originally. So it makes no sense that the UN split the land by giving 55% to the Jews and only 45% to the Palestinians. It shouldn't be almost equal. This isn't a divorce on Judge Judy, and the irony of a conservative supporting government equality.
We're Jewish Wall Street bankers for land equality.
Sharing, sharing, sharing,
sharing,
sharing, sharing, sharing,
50-50. And according to the historian Elon Pape, this systematic ethnic cleansing was going on prior to the 1948 war, and that's what motivated the Arabs to come to help them. Oh, so the war wasn't just with Palestinians, but with all the neighboring Arab countries. Which ones? Egypt, Jordan, Syria, and Iraq formed the Arab League, which sounds kind of like a superhero group. But unlike DC Comics, the Justice League, this group's goal was to kill the Jews and steal their land. So they could probably be called the No Justice League. Now on Wikipedia, it says the goal of the Arab League was to strengthen and coordinate the cultural, political, economic, and social programs of its members and to mediate disputes among them or between them and third parties. But in 1947, that goal turned into...
Oh, I've been shot! But I'm confused. I thought you were gonna mediate the dispute. Don't you read Wikipedia?
But I assume they lost that war because the center of their flag looks like a sea monkey colony. That's really offensive. Well, originally I was gonna say semen, which is a kid's other favorite childhood pet. You're confusing the alien by not laying out the full story all at once. I'll explain it to you in four simple steps. First, the UN split the land 55-45, even though the Jews only owned 15% to begin with.
Dude, go over to the UN building quick. They're handing everything out 50-50. I was just there. How do you think I lost my right arm?
Second, Zionist militia ethnically cleansed the Palestinians to clear the land for a new state.
Now we're holding you in psychiatric evaluation until you admit your uncle was too ugly to finger bang. That's not true. My uncle could get laid. We don't count Uganda. Never mind then.
Third, the Arab League tried to come to their rescue, but lost.
The Jews ethnically cleanse, but they don't lose wars like I do!
Why do Nazis walk like they're constipated?
I am furious!
Fourth, Israel won the war in 1948 and then conquered the land that the UN had allocated for Palestine. I barely even speak human languages. Say it again, but slowly. Okay, so first the Jews legally bought under 15% of the land. Then the UN gave them 55% of the land. Then they won the War of 1948 and conquered up to 78% of the land, leaving the Palestinians with only 22%. Then in subsequent wars, they took even that. But yet the UN never got mad at Israel because they acted subtly and cutesy about it. The UN acts like it's when your girlfriend asks to have just a bite of your sandwich, but then she just devours the whole thing and the UN's like, I want to get mad, but you're adorable. Now, a ceasefire divided them along the Green Line. That's a bizarre name. Well, why is it called the Green Line? On the ceasefire map, they drew the line in green, so it became known as the Green Line. Maybe they call it the Green Line because Israel can only hold it with American money. Don't blame Israel for having rich allies, but blame the Arab League for having no brotherhood. After the War of 1948, Jordan took control of the West Bank, the land east of the Green Line, and Egypt took control of the Gaza Strip. So here it is, the Jordans going, how can Israel not respect the independence of Palestine when we stole the land from them a few years earlier? What are you talking about? The Palestinians were given equal representation in all government. There was no animosity. Oh, no animosity, the way in 1951, a Palestinian assassinated the King of Jordan. By that logic, when Jordan says, how can you take Palestine? Israel can reply, we're just protecting it from you. So you're saying, because foreign Arab leaders were abusive, that gives Israel the right to deny Nakba refugees to return to their homes. I'd hate to see an Israeli adoption agency. Because your father abused you, I'm gonna abuse you too. Bend over and I'll beat you with this spatula. Which is an ironic web of choice, because on the issue of land ownership, I like to flip-flop. Let's end the episode here. But first, a word from an unexplained narrator. Did you know if you sign up for the mailing list on the Hypocrite Twins website, you get access to an unlisted episode on immigration? And if you're subscribed, make sure to turn on notifications so you don't miss an episode. You know what you should do with our videos on social media.
Sharing.
In next week's video transmission to my home planet, I seek to understand the War of 1967. I'll see you then. I squat to produce organic paints for the Israel map. I've been eating nothing but avocados.
The British find this very disgusting. Avocados? At least we'll get a new Green Line.
I'm sure we're gonna get a bunch of people talking shit in the YouTube comments, so there's only one way to avoid this aggression. Wave your UN resolutions.
One love. One love.